gentle viewers, and welcome to another episode of Alistair Reviews It. And today I'm going to be doing my fall book haul, y'all, or whatever assortment of those words I decided for the title. This is actually my second time filming this because I had technical difficulties with the camera and it focused on my microphone and not on anything else in the video. So I am redoing it, but that's fine, because I actually got a couple other books in between that time, so I get to haul a little bit more books, y'all. Without further ado, I want to start with two books I was sent to my P.O. Box. So my P.O. Box is below. Some people have been sending stuff to my house. Please just send it to the P.O. Box for privacy reasons. I actually don't know how people got my house address. But if you want to send me anything, just send it there and I will receive it. I got Malice from John Gwynn from Ian McCarthy. I am so thankful. I've seen so many people talk about this on Reddit and on BookTube, actually, also, how much they like it and how John Gwynn is a underappreciated fantasy auteur. I know Peter Petrick, I'll link his channel below, he raves about the series, so I'm actually pretty excited to start it. Probably not until next year, obviously. And then I also got Priest of Bones by Peter McLean. And I got this one from Ashley, I hope I get this right, but Ashlyn Denis, and I am looking forward to reading this one. I know Troy Butcher, the author of Lies of Descent, told me that this book is amazing. It's a grimdark book. It's kind of a mob mentality. I know somebody comes back, Priestlet comes back from war, and then realizes that his territory has been taken over, and then he decides to take it back. So I'm very excited, and I know this one's big war fantasy, but honestly, I don't know much beyond that. Let's see. But it seems like very classic war fantasy, so I'm very excited for these two. So thank you very, very, very much. The rest of the books, I'm going to get into my book of the month. I do pay for the subscription. Book of the month books that I've gotten since my last book haul. Then I'm going to get into my the books I've gotten for basically a discount or just to treat yourself. And then I'm going to get into the books I got for my birthday. And lastly, my most highly anticipated read books that I've got. Those are the categories. Starting with Book of the Month. I got Winter Counts by David Heska Wandley Whedon. This is a Native American thriller. And when I say I got it, my husband actually got it, but I'm hauling it because I'm going to read it. And so whenever he gets a book, but I'm going to read it also, I'm also going to haul it, even though it's probably going to be on his actual bookshelf. This is a thriller on a Native American reservation where the Native American tribe system and the American legal system haven't worked in terms of solving a drug-related case. The main protagonist decides to, along with his ex-girlfriend, figure out what's happening themselves. I'm actually very excited for this one. Next, I have three books, all from Alice Hoffman. So I was very much, I've already talked about this book, and I think I've showed this book in another video. I was very much in a practical magic vibe for all of Halloween, all of the spooky season, and I decided to get this one. And then my husband decided to get Magic Lessons, the prequel. It's like the pre-prequel that just came out. And then I was like, oh, well, I can't have the pre-prequel and not have a prequel, so I got the prequel. Practical Magic, if you don't know, follows two sisters, Jillian and Sally, as they grow up and they discover what it means to be witches in modern day life. It's a coming of age story. It's a love story. It's a very woman empowering story. It's very much like the movie, but also like, it's like the director's cut of the movie with a couple of changes, I would say. But I actually, this is one of the instances where I actually like the movie more. But I also really, really like the book. The book is a very good book. I just really, really, really love the movie. And I'm actually looking forward. I probably won't get to these until next fall, next spooky season. But I'm excited for these two. This one follows the aunts in the 60s, 70s. The aunts who raise Jillian, Sally. And then this one goes all the way back to Salem, the first Owen woman. And basically follows her story. I am already stacking up all the books I really want for next Halloween season. There are so many books that I want to read. and I cannot wait. But I'm trying to get into the Christmas mood lately. Okay, I also got Purenzi by Susanna Clarke. I was about to say Susanna Clarke by Purenzi. This is a mythological fantasy, and it all takes place in this one house. And I think it's going to be a little bit more literary than most of the books I read. And it's also a little shorter. So I think this might be a good book between all the big books I am going to be reading here soon. Next, we're going to be talking about the books I've just collected over the course of this time. Starting with My Best Friend's Exorcism by Grady Hendrix. I finished the Southern Book Club's Guide to Reading. The Southern Book Club's Guide to Slaying Vampires by Grady Hendrix, and I was absolutely in love. And I made my husband read it, even though my husband was the first one who bought it. And he was in love with it. And then he was like, I need to read this book now. We got the book. We both read it. I didn't expect to read it because I had a different things to read in November. But I read it and I really, really liked it. And I would say he's my favorite fantasy. I would say he's my favorite horror author, at least right now, from my little dip into horror. And this book is awesome. Like, his books look like they're going to be campy. They're not campy. They're really, really well done. They will be funny. And they will, like, this one is very, like, 80s. But it's done so well. This follows Abby and Gretchen in the late 1980s as they go out with their friends. And then Gretchen gets possessed by a demon. And then it follows Abby trying to figure out what to do with Gretchen, is possessed by a demon. Everybody is not helping her at all, and she feels very alone, and she's trying to figure out how to do this while being a teenager and going to school, and it's very, very, very good. It was an unexpected buy, but a very... Plus, look at this cover. Wait, let me focus it. Look at this cover. It is a gorgeous cover. It looks like a VHS from, like, an old Blockbuster. Look at that. I love this cover. And I really like it's paperback. It's meant to be paperback. Next, I have Dracula by Bram Stoker and Frankenstein by Mary Shelley. So I don't think I have to explain what these books are about. I have not read them. My husband read Frankenstein. He hasn't read Dracula, though. But again, these are two books I am adding to next year. I just got a really, really good deal. You know how you get really good deals after a season is done on, like, Halloween stuff or on, like, a... like Christmas stuff in January. This is basically what that was, and these are very pretty covers, and they're kind of decoration too, so I'm like, let's do it. Next I have The Unbroken Name by A.K. Larkwood. This follows a woman, Sorwi, as she partners with a mage and decides to become his assassin and basically turn her back on her god and her people. It's a high fantasy. I think it might be YA. And I was looking at it, I thought it was about orcs, but I guess it's not about orcs. And I was like, why not? It was very discounted, and I was like, this might be a book that I would like. Next I have Big Damn Hero. It's a Firefly series taking place between Firefly and the Serenity, the actual movie. This was discounted, so I was like, why not? Let's grab it. I've heard really good things about the in-between books that Joss Whedon has helped create, and other people like James Lovegrove is the author for this book, but the original story and the consulting editor is Joss Whedon, and I love Joss Whedon is my, I would say Brandon Sanderson is my Joss Whedon of the book world. I love everything by Joss Whedon, love everything by Brandon Sanderson, and so I'm excited about this one. I think that this might be a good book in between, just like Perenzi. Might be a good book in between all the books, you know, kind of a palate cleanser, and also gets me back into the Firefly verse. Just did a podcast for Slayerfest 98 where we talked about the first episode of Firefly with a couple other people. We'll link that in the description box below. Next I have We Hunt the Flame by Hafsa Faisal, and I saw this on Times's list of 100 best fantasy books of all time, and I've seen this in a couple TikToks, so I was like, why not pick it? And I heard that this is very much kind of like Mulan, where this woman decides to disguise her identity as a woman, enter in as a man, and she basically needs to do this in order to be able to feed her family, and then she embarks on a quest to find a lost artifact that might be able to help her really free her people. I'm very excited about this. This is the first book that I know of that I've read from a Muslim author, and I'm very excited, especially since it was on the Times 100 list. I probably won't get to this book until next year. Let me know if I should bump it up. Next, I have Firebrand by Kirsten Britton. This is the sixth book in the Green Rider series, and I actually think that this is the most slept-on fantasy series of all time. It's an epic series that takes place in the Kingdom of Sycordia and follows Kerrigan Gladion, a Green Rider, a messenger for the king, who has special abilities just like all the other Green Riders do. This is the sixth book. I've been trying to slowly collect these books, but they seem to be nowhere. She typically takes about five to, I think the longest time she's taken is like 10 years to come out with one of her newer books. And I know that she doesn't have a plan to finish them. She wants everything to finish organically. And so far, I think it's working out brilliantly. I love every single one of her books. It's definitely kind of classical high fantasy with a modern twist. And I think that everybody should check out The Green Rider if they can. I have Crossroads of Midnight. Yeah, Crossroads of Midnight by Robert Jordan. And this is his, 10th book in the Wheel of Time series. And I've been slowly collecting the hardback editions because they're, collectibles. And I've been making my way through the Wheel of Time series. I'm going to be finishing the third here soon and putting out a review. I've been working on the third for a while, but then life kind of got in the way. I got really, really, really busy at work and I had to put it down. So I think I'm going to restart the third and just go through. I'm definitely going to finish that before the end of the year in December. So I don't know if I'm going to put out a review in December or January, but it's definitely going to be one of those. Maybe December, because I'll have a little bit more time. Next, I have The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas. This book follows a main protagonist that goes to a prep school, a very white prep school, and that's very different from her own world. And these two worlds collide and they're shattered when somebody who she loves deeply is brutalized by the police. Newsweek calls it The Hate U Give is a vital look at racism and police violence. Next, I have Cemetery Boys by Aiden Thomas, and I actually reviewed this kind of my wrap-up for Spooky Season, so if you want to watch that, it's linked in the description box below. And this is a Latinx urban fantasy story with trans representation. The main character, Yadriel, is a trans man, and he is in a part of a Brujo community, a witch community, like a Latin witch community that are the custodians for the dead, and he summons a dead boy, and he cannot get rid of this dead boy. There is some romance in here, and I thought it was a very, very cool debut from Aiden Thomas. Next, I have Surrender Your Sons by Adam Sass. My husband and I actually already finished this book. We were reading it in my November TBR. If you want to look at my November TBR, I talked about it, and I'm going to be talking more about it in the wrap-up, but it follows a protagonist who is sent in nowadays time frame to a straight conversion camp. He's gay, so he's sent to a conversion camp on an island, and it's kind of a YA thriller. You follow the character throughout, and there's kind of a murder mystery plot on the island that they're taken to, and I will say it's a very worthy read, so pick it up if you can. So next I'm going to be getting into the books I got for my birthday. First off is The Grey Bastards by Jonathan French. I've heard really good things about this book. It follows a protagonist who is half orc, and his society is being, his community is being kind of demolished by actual full orcs, and it's called The Grey Bastards. I've been wanting to read this for a while, and because they're half orcs, they're kind of ostracized from society. They don't belong to one caste or another. They're attacked because of that, so it really just follows your plight. I've been wanting to read this for a while. I finally saw this really well, really discounted. And I was like, well, might as well pick it up. I got it for myself for my birthday. Okay, this was a birthday present to me. Next are basically all of the books my husband gave me. Starting with One Word Kill by Mark Lawrence. And I love Mark Lawrence's. Mark Lawrence is a hit or miss for me. Sometimes I really don't like his series. Sometimes I really like it. The one I really like is the Book of the Ancestor series by Mark Lawrence, starting with Red Sister. Very good. Awesome books. And my husband got me One Word Kill. So I have the books that my husband gave me, and I have One Word Kill by Mark Lawrence. So he's a hit or miss for me. Sometimes I really like his series, sometimes I don't. Like, I really, really love Book of the Ancestor, starts with Red Sister. It is so freaking good. It's one of my favorite fantasies. But then, like, what is it, Prince of Thorns? It just wasn't my cup of tea, I'll say it, because I know a lot of people like it. It just wasn't my cup of tea. So this is One Word Kill, and it takes place in the 80s, I believe, and the main protagonist is going to be dying soon, and he kind of attends these, like, I think it's like fantasy games with other people, and he starts falling for a girl. The mysterious man tells him that this girl is in danger, and so he starts to try to like solve the puzzles and figure out what he can do to actually save her. I know that this is a sci-fi, so I'm sure that there's a lot more sci-fi that goes into it. So, and it's kind of a novella, really, because it's so small. So this might be one of those really good books in between books I will pick up. Next I have The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Schwab. So I never actually finished the first book in The Darker Shade of Magic series. I could tell that it was like well written, but I just never bought into it. My husband got me this one because he saw that it was highly anticipated, The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue, and it's actually on my TBR for this month. I've finished a little bit of it, but then some other books came up I've been highly anticipating, and I dropped it for those. But from what I read, I've really, really enjoyed. It follows a woman who is both blessed and cursed. She asks the devil to basically give her immortality, and with that immortality means that she cannot leave a lasting impression on this world or on anybody in the world, and that is her curse. I'm very much enjoying it. From what I read, I probably have to reread a little bit more of it. But once I'm done with these other books, I'm definitely going to pick it back up again, and I will finish it before the end of the year. Next, I have Deadly Education by Naomi Novik. My husband saw everybody raving about this on BookTube, and he decided to get it for me. And I know that this is a dark academia book. I don't think I've read much dark academia, unless you consider Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo dark academia. I think it's a very confusing genre for me, but from what I know of, this book doesn't really have a plot. It's not plot driven, but it's character and setting driven, and they are in a school, and the school wants to murder them, so they have to join forces with other students, and there's no real teachers. I'm very curious about it. I think it's actually a gorgeous book, and it has like really, really gorgeous like images inside. So I'm hoping that I do enjoy it. And then again, this is a shorter book that would be great in between those larger books I am reading. Elantris, the leather-bound edition by Brandon Sanderson. Oh my goodness, I love Elantris. It's Wraithen. Oh, Wraithen. Look at this artwork. It's just so gorgeous. And for those who don't know, Brandon Sanderson, so this was Brandon Sanderson's Fush. So here I have the mass market paperback. So this is Brandon Sanderson's first published book that he wrote. And it takes place in a fantasy world where the magic system has gone wrong. And everybody who has this magic system, everybody who used to be known as living gods, are now basically walking zombies. And they've entrenched them inside of this like previously grand palace. And one of these main protagonists wakes up one day and he is one of these zombies. And he goes in. And so there's multiple viewpoints. He's engaged to somebody who goes there without knowing that he became one of these zombie people, and it is actually really good. There's a lot of political intrigue. I was told that there wasn't much action. There's actually quite a bit of action, maybe less so than most fantasies, but it is so good. And I know that right now it's a standalone, so if you want to read a standalone from Brandon Sanderson, I would recommend either this one or Warbreaker. Love them both. I think Warbreaker is my favorite though. And yeah. So now we're going to be getting into the books I'm too excited to read that I have and that are in my book haul. And a lot of them just came out. So starting with Legendborn by Tracy Dion. This is I believe it's YA, but it's a fantasy book. It's an urban fantasy book. And the main protagonist finds out that she has powers. And she's also going to it's like a high school program, but at a college. It's a college program for high schoolers. And she finds this society that harkens back to Arthurian times, which is where her powers come from. And I'm very much excited to read this one. I heard it's very nuanced. I heard it's very refreshing for this fantasy genre. And I'm going to be reading this before the end of the year. Next, I have Leviathan Wakes by James S.A. Corey. So I will not be reading this by the end of the year. This is probably one of the first books I pick up in January. I'll probably put this in my January TBR. We'll see. And I'm very much excited for it. I want more space operas. I read To Sleep in the Sea of Stars this year by Christopher Paolini. Really liked the book. And it made me think. I started rewatching Battlestar Galactica, the newer version. And I loved it. I really loved it. And I just want more space operas. I think we all just deserve more space operas. Getting the Ninth, another space opera. I think it's just gotten me in that mood. And I've heard that this one is great. It's probably right now my top sci-fi that I want to read. Next, I have The Sword of Kaigen by M.L. Wang. And this is highly anticipated for me because I know it is self-published. So it's rare. Well, I don't know if it's rare. But usually the books that get hype on Reddit, on BookTok, on BookTube, tend to be traditionally published books. But this is a self-published book that has gotten a lot of attention recently for kind of redefining the fantasy genre. And it follows, I think it's two protagonists, one mother who comes from a faraway land, who used to be a fighter, and one 14-year-old who comes from a legendary family of fighters that helped to defend this peninsula, this state that is part of a peninsula. And they can wield, they can wield like ice blades and different kinds of powers. And then he finds out that the entire state is kind of built on a bed of lies, and the story gets a little bit more interesting from there. So this is another one that I probably won't start until the beginning of next year. Both of these are ones that I probably won't start until the beginning of next year, but I'm very much looking forward to reading them. Okay, It's that time. It's my two most highly anticipated reads of the year. I had the audiobook and I had the Kindle version, but I didn't actually have the physical version of Rage of Dragons. I love Rage of Dragons, and it's an African fantasy. It's an African revenge fantasy that follows the main protagonist, Tao, as he goes through his revenge. Something happens really bad to him. I don't want to give any spoilers away. And he basically decides, I'm getting revenge no matter what the costs. And you follow him in his drive as he goes, he trains, and he becomes the best person, the best fighter he can be in order to exact the revenge that he believes that he deserves. And on the 10th of this month, on the 10th of November, Rage of Dragons came out, and I have been reading it. I have not finished it. I thought I was going to finish it in a day, but it didn't happen. And I just keep on getting, like, anxiety while reading it, because I'm like, these are characters who I have invested a lot of time in loving, and I'm very much enjoying it. But then my last and most highly anticipated read of the year came out, Rhythm of War from the Stormlight Archive. This is the fourth book in Brandon Sanderson's Stormlight Archive. His, I would believe, what he would like to be his banner series, his ode to fantasy, his contribution, his biggest contribution, and this is his fourth book, and it's gorgeous. It is gorgeous. So, I've been really struggling between these two, reading them, and because of that, I haven't even finished either of them yet, even though this one just really came out. It's a struggle, but for Rhythm of War, Rhythm of War is in the Stormlight Archive, and anybody who is nervous about approaching Grant Sanderson's book, yes, they're all within the Cosmere universe, but all of his series take place individually, so you can read them and really enjoy yourself. And then if you decide to pick up more books in his series, then you get really nice Easter eggs, like these two books are in the same world. Well, not world, but in the same universe, and I really like that. But this is the fourth book in the Stormlight Archive, and the Stormlight Archive takes place in Roshar, a world much like our own, slightly smaller, with, it's like the earth is much harsher, and the climate is much different, and there's this storm that just destroys everything in its path, but it fills up gems with light, and people use this light, and people use these gems as currency, and people build their houses in order to avoid being destroyed by the storm that comes ever so often. There are many distinct and diverse religions and peoples within these books, and each book kind of, there's a lot of characters and a lot of different stories, and this is the fourth book, so he's going to be doing five books for like the first arc, and then five more books for the last arc of the Stormlight Archive series. I've been wanting to read this book forever. I have Oathbringer, but Winifred, I think, ate the Oathbringer book jacket, so that's not good. That concludes my fall book haul, y'all. I cannot wait to see you guys later. Please comment below whether you guys have read or are going to be reading any of these books. And if you know any books I should pick up, what are you guys reading? What are you guys doing? Are you guys having a good soon-to-be holiday season? Please stay safe, stay well, and enjoy yourselves. Adios, gentle viewers. Until next time.